That's right. I'm living in a trailer. Sort of.
I tell the good jokes.
Okay, so like the title said, I'm living in this trailer. But there's a really good reason I'm living in this trailer. It's because this trailer is parked at the Texas coast, which is where I'll be for most of the rest of the year. The trailer gets dragged back and forth from Austin to the coast and from the coast to Austin probably twice a year. I've spent a few months down here guiding for redfish, and then I'll spend a few months in Central Texas guiding for bass. It's awesome. Basically, I get to cherry pick the best times of year to do these two different types of guiding that I like to do. I'm lucky, right? It's great, except for the fact that I am here in this trailer by myself for most of the fall. My wife and the kids, they love to come down and fish. They love to come down and hang out at the beach, but they live in Austin, so they're not here all the time. But they're here quite a bit. And when I'm working every day, it's not like I'm really a whole lot of fun. I'm on the water all day. I come home, eat dinner, and I go to bed. And occasionally I make a YouTube video. The thing is, the fall is hands down my favorite time to fish for redfish on the Texas coast. So I'm really excited about that. Wake up every morning, check the weather, check the tides, check the wind, and I'm good to go. So yeah, it's gonna be a fun few months down here. If you get a chance, definitely come on down. I'm all booked up, but there's a bunch of other great guides I work with. If you wanna get on the water this year, just let me know. We should be able to make it happen. So like I said, pretty busy. And I'm not gonna be able to make an elaborate YouTube video for you guys this week, but I thought I'd do a little question and answer session. So I got two things. So later on this week, Thursday, September 30th, I'll be doing a live stream with Gerber Gear on Instagram. So check that out. I'll be answering all your questions then, and we're actually gonna be giving away some prizes. So 5 p.m. Thursday, September 30th. Check out the Gerber Gear Instagram page for more details. All right, I got a lot of questions on these last couple of videos, my redfish video and some of the older videos, some questions that are a little bit longer than are easy to answer in the comments. So I thought, let's answer a couple of questions. All right, so here it goes. Gotta get the glasses on. Getting old is awesome. All right, so this is a question from an older video, my video about rafts and whether a raft was the best fishing boat out there. And the question is from Jacob Miller, and he says, Alvin, do you have a specific brand you feel is one of the best? I don't really have a lot of experience with a lot of different brands. We have two of the Air Super Puma rafts, and that's been a really popular one for a long time. The two that we have are over 10 years old, and Air is really good about, if you do have to have a raft repaired, they're really good about repairing them for you. So I can recommend the Air rafts. I know there's a bunch of other really good rafts out there, but those are the ones that I have experience with, and I've had really good luck. All right, thanks, Jacob. Okay, so Tim Richardson asked, what about topwater poppers? He says, I've done a lot of spin fishing for reds and trout and have had good luck with big poppers. Do you ever fish for them? Oh, do you ever fish them? If so, when and how? Thanks. Well, actually, Tim, I think that probably the first 10 redfish I caught on a fly were caught on a giant deer hair bass bug. I'm not sure why we don't fish topwaters nearly as much as we used to. I do know that if it's an overcast day and I'm not seeing fish, you know, fish aren't tailing, And I know there's fish around, but I can't see them. Sometimes I will put a big popper on and just blind cast to cover water. And I've had some days where that has made the difference between catching some fish and not catching some fish. Sometimes in the fall, when the fish are in big pods, poppers are good. You can just drop a popper on top of a big pot of fish, and almost always one of them's going to eat it. So we do throw poppers, not as much as I used to. I know a lot of the guys in Louisiana, Venice area, they throw big poppers for those big fish. So they will definitely work. Okay, so here's another question from Sky is Womb One. I hope I'm saying that right. Sky is Womb One asks, if I'm kayaking, will I miss a lot of my chance of spotting them if I'm sitting? Or do they make enough surface disturbance? I know standing will be better, but I can't move very fast while standing in the yak. All right, so I have fished for redfish a little bit out of a kayak, a lot out of a canoe, and you know, we use a canoe pretty much the same way as you would a kayak. Most of the time we take the canoe or a kayak to get to a spot that we're gonna suspect that there'll be fish, and then we'll get out and wade and just drag the kayaks behind us. Now, if you can stand up, one thing that you can do, I used to do a lot, is paddle into the wind and then stand up on the boat, kayak, canoe, paddleboard, whatever you got, and then let the wind push you back across the flat. Then that way you're moving and you're up high and you can see the fish. And that seems to work pretty well. Now, if the wind's blowing fast, you know, it's gonna be a pretty quick cast, so it can get pretty exciting pretty fast, but it'll definitely work. But I do know people who sit down in the kayaks and fish, and they're pretty quiet, and they even though they're pretty close to the water, they can't see as well, but they don't spook the fish as often. So a lot of times you can get pretty close to a fish if you're sitting down in the kayak. So whatever's easiest for you, I would try both ways. If you don't mind standing up, it may make the fishing a little bit easier. All right, this is another great question from Michael E. Michael says, great videos. They have definitely helped my fishing skills. His question is wade fishing practical on the Texas coast, or is a boat required? I'm wondering if a boat is needed to get good visual of these fish, and if muck, weeds, access make wading the central and south Texas coast very difficult. You know, a boat of some type will definitely make it easier, but for a long time, all I did was drive to a spot, get out, and start walking. And we caught plenty of fish that way. Me and several of my buddies who are prominent redfish guides around here now, that's how we started. We just walked in and wade fish because we didn't have boats, we didn't have skiffs, we didn't have canoes, we didn't have kayaks, we didn't have anything. All we had was a pair of wading boots, a rod, some flies, and a desire to catch them. And that's all you really need. Google Earth has really made this a lot easier than it used to be. We used to actually rely on paper maps and you know, just trial and error. We'd drive in and see if we could get to a spot without getting stuck, and then we'd figure out if we could actually wade without losing our boots. But yeah, you don't have to have a boat. Really, just like a lot of other aspects of fly fishing, you can make this as simple or as complicated as you want. And in a lot of ways, I kind of long for those days, the simple days when we had like the only gear we had was the stuff we could stick in our pockets and maybe a fanny pack and a bottle of water, a rod and some flies, and then we'd just like set off and, you know, maybe walk for 2 hours just to cover the perimeter of a lake that we thought may have some redfish in it. A lot of times we didn't find any fish, but a lot of, you know, we did find fish often enough to keep us coming back. And that is one of the reasons why I'm doing what I'm doing right now, was those days just slogging around through the flats looking for fish. All right, y'all. Thanks for watching this. I'm going to be on the water tomorrow, the next day, and the day after that, and who knows how many days, but I'm going to try to keep up with these videos. If you have any questions, you have any ideas, just throw them in the comments. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up, maybe subscribe, hit that little bell notification, all that YouTube stuff. I really, Really appreciate it. I'll see you in the next one. And in the meantime, good luck on the water.